Hey guys, I'm Captain Duck, and this is the Dwarf Fortress 3D tutorial part 20. 21 even, and this is the real 21. Last time I fended off a human caravan, they all died on this little beautiful trap thing over here. Most of them. Let me turn off my military. Remember to do that once the enemies are gone. Also, in the last video, I showed the new option, the soldier can go in all door options. If you press O, you have this options menu. And with the I button, you can change the outdoors options. Stay indoors, can go outdoors, and soldiers can go outdoors. I had soldiers can go outdoors for my big battle. So the normal dwarves just stay inside and don't get themselves slaughtered. But now, dwarves can go outdoors again. Okay, well, let's go over to what I really wanted to do, and that's nobles. Finally start explaining them. First of all, I prepared and made a couple of big rooms over here, and I smoothed the walls and engraved them. Remember, with DS you can smooth walls, so they look nice, and with then DE you can engrave them. And it always works, which is really handy for nobles. Yeah, most of the noble information you can find in the noble menu. If you press N for nobles. As you can see, I've pleased all of them, if you know the game. And yeah, this is just a couple of them. I don't have that much yet. There's more to come. There's a baron, and the hammerer, and whatnot. And yeah, Master Chief is mayor now. Predator is manager, horde master, and town broker. And but how in hell you pronounce it, but it's just captain of the guard. And Squall is dungeon master. Yeah, the problem is, these guys, they want stuff. If you press on one of them, you press enter, yeah, you can see what they already want. This guy, the dungeon master, wants a lot. Splint it off. Yeah, this is what he has. This is what he needs. Or what he wants. Now he's a splendid office, a grand bedroom, fine dining room, burial chamber, two chests, one cabinet, one weapon rack, and one armor stand. That's all kind of stuff you have to give them. First of all, yeah, as you can see, there's all kinds of weird stuff over here. Your basic noble bedroom has, six things. First of all, a bed. The best bed you have, as you can see. Well, you can't see that over here. He wants an armor stand. He wants a weapon rack. A cabinet. And most of them want two coffers or containers. So I built those over here too. And also they want an office with a table. As you can see, this is an office room. The throne makes it a room, and the table makes a room, and it makes it the dining room, basically, for this guy, for the noble. You'll plant stuff. Let me show how to make them. You know how to make beds? That's just easy, but the trick with nobles is to make all the other stuff. But it's not that hard, you can make most of it at the masons. Let me expand the menu here. Well, here's the armor stand you saw. There's the coffins, which we also made and also need for the dungeon master. Cabinets. The coffers. Those are the containers the most of the nobles want. Most nobles want two of these. Statues aren't really noble necessary, but they can pretty up a room. So you might want one. Tables, chairs, you know, thrones, and the weapon rack, of course. Well, with those you can actually, if you build those, you have a nice little noble set to build. Door 2, a cabinet, two coffers, a table, a statue, and a throne. This is basically your noble set. You want to make one set of these for about every noble. Let's get the screen back to normal. Now you have that, you actually need to place them. I've replaced a lot, so as you can see. Let me build a little noble room over here. Well, first of all, he wants a bed. And with nobles, the quality matters a lot. The better the quality of the bed, the better they like it. And yeah, so I'm pressing X to expand the list, just like I did with the weapon traps. As you can see, there's tons of different qualities. The best quality I have at the moment is with the 3 bar, so I'm using one of those. Well, now I'm placing an armor stand using the same menu. And I want the best one, but I've used those already, but here's the best one. The weapon rack is also in the build menu over here, BR. I want the best one too. And then I want the cabinet, also in the build menu somewhere. I think it was F. Yeah, here, cabinet. The best quality is this one. Now I want the container, which is H, or yeah, that's the coffer we were talking about. Not a coffin, but a coffer. The one with the 3 bars. And I want another one with H. There. Well, also, let's make this a standard room and give him a table too. Best table I have is probably this one. Best chair I have is probably this one. Now, this is a whole set, and most nobles will be pleased with this. Once it's done, of course, you'll have to assign it to someone, which is pretty easy. You just have to assign 3 things. First, the bed. Make a room out of that. Make a room out of the chair, and make a room out of the table. So now we have a bedroom, a dining room, and a study. Now it's just a question of assigning the noble to sleep here. Press A, and most of your nobles will stand at the top. Here's Master Chief or Mayor. Well, let's relocate him to here. Let's give him this room, this chair so he can eat or work, and a stable so he can eat. Let's see if he's still happy. Yeah. Now he's a splendid office, and more stuff than he already had. And yeah, he likes it. So that's the basic of the taking care of nobles, what you have to do. The problem is you have to do this because of this requires demands and mandates. So you see, the mayor has put a mandate that he can't export zinc items. Which sucks, but well, I don't have any zinc at all, so it's no problem. But sometimes it can be a bother. If you want to export some platinum, and one of your nobles puts a ban on platinum exporting, that can be a bitch. But if you want, you can kill the noble then, and the mandate will be gone. You'll have to figure out how to do it yourself, though. And let's see, I think I covered most of the basics. Shall I? 1 second. Alright. Yeah, I've shown most of the do what you have to do to please nobles, and how you can please them. Some of them can actually work for you. This is the standard setup you get. You start actually with the mayor, the manager, the hardmaster, and the broker. These all have different names. The mayor is just the mayor. The town manager is important, I'll get to him in a minute. The horde master will count everything in the fortress. Because of the fortress, well, he's not good enough. There would be should be information here and over here. This will become more accurate with the horde master, if he is good. Wrong screen. The town broker is for trading with the other races, with the caravans. And which gets us back to the manager job. Which is actually a special menu. If you press U for the unit list and M for manager, you get a special screen where you can issue commands at once. And let's give some. These are nice for building too. Press Q and you can type in anything you want to do. Like I want to make some rock doors. Well, you construct rock doors, press enter. How many quantity is how many you want to make. I want to make 30. Which is the max per order, it seems. Or if you want to make some iron spears, make 5 of those, that works too. The problem is these have to get validated by the manager, and to do that the manager has to needs free time and a chair, an office to work at, which he should have, so he should manage that and approve it at one time. And once it gets approved, your dwarves will actually do it. You can actually see it. It's in action if I go to the letterworks, probably. Yeah. These commands are all issued by the manager instead of me. And with this you can queue up much more to much less shops. And yeah, it's an easy thing you have to use. Can use. Anyway, I'm really out of time too, so it'll be a noble update. And yeah, that'll be all. See you later, guys.